Hi, welcome to another show, Florida's Great Northwest. I'm your host, Larry Sassano, and I'm the president of Florida's Great Northwest. Today we're at Chipola College, and we're actually in the tech garage. And today my guests, Darwin Gilmore and John Gardner, welcome. Darwin is the Dean of Workforce and Economic Development, and John is the automotive instructor here at the tech garage. This is pretty interesting. I think being on site like this makes the show a lot more fun for us. And I think we're going to first start off with Darwin and ask Darwin about his background. And how is your background related to being the Dean of Workforce and Economic Development?
Thanks, Larry. We really appreciate you guys taking time to come here on site. My background is I've been involved in engineering and manufacturing for over 30 years. I'm a hometown guy here from Marianna, but graduated from Chipola, went to Auburn University for an engineering degree, and co-opted Gulf Power at a time when Ed Addison was there, had a great experience. And what has brought me to this point is after I worked at Unimac for about 15 years and then my own businesses, manufacturing, precision machining for about 15 years, we're out looking for work, and everywhere we would go, we would try to say, let's recruit manufacturing businesses to come here to our area, because the more the merrier. Get these manufacturing companies to locate here, they will need subcontractors and we'll get a lot of work. What happened was at every turn, the impediment was workforce. At every turn, people would say, that's not gonna happen, they're not gonna come here. I would say, let's go recruit Caterpillar. If they come, that'll be a 1,000-job plant. And it'll be, you know, we know that manufacturing has a multiplicity of jobs that are greater than any other industry sector. So we wanted to target those industries to bring them here. All the way to the governor's office, we went talking about that. And the bottom line was, since the workforce impediment continued to pop up, there was a job opportunity that came open here at Chipola for the workforce dean, and I thought maybe I could have a chance at being part of the solution.
Yeah. It seems like a really good fit. So, and John, how about your background? Being in the automotive industry for a while, how did you end up in Chipola College here?
Well, I started out as a technician. I went to a General Motors school in South Florida at Sheridan and Broward Community College. And then from there, I started working at a dealership as a technician. And I taught some classes from General Motors, some of their training classes. And I kind of like to teach. So I did it there at nights. And I taught at a technical school down in South Florida. And then the opportunity arose to come up to North Florida. My wife took a job up at the prison up here. And it was through a health corps scholarship of Nova Southeastern. And we come up here, visit, fell in love with the area, and moved up here. And there was an opening here at Chipola, so I started teaching. It was about 15 years ago. Just absolutely love to teach. That's my passion. These kids, these like Darwin said, the need in the workforce, and to put into these kids and have them come back 3 or 4 years from now, being productive members of society and doing real well in these dealerships, making a lot of money, and it's just very, very rewarding.
It is. It's a great feeling.
It is. Yeah. There's nothing like it.
Darwin, you talk about career tech education. Why is that such a valuable tool for any individual today?
Yeah, that's a good question. The new economy has induced a lot of change. The new economy has taught us that, you know, career pathways have traditionally been thought to be, oh, go get a college degree, and then you'll easily find a job out in the workforce and life will be good. But in fact, some data, some interesting statistics, 66% of high school graduates leave and enroll in college, but only a fourth of those graduate. Of that one-fourth, half of them can't find a job that meets their need. In other words, they're underemployed, a gray-collar job, they call it. And what's interesting in career tech ed is for everybody, because what's not changed since 1950, if you look at the ratio of jobs that are out there available, the ratio is 1-to-7 for every one advanced degree, a master's or higher job, there's 2 bachelor's degree jobs and 7 skilled labor jobs.
Oh, yeah.
So that ratio has been consistent, and in fact across all industries it's been consistent. So What's happened now is the need for the technology has been so prevalent that we're terming this gold collar. What you're used to hearing about white collar jobs and blue collar jobs, the new term and the new phrase, and what we'll learn a little bit more about, these automotive techs will very well represent a gold collar job where the technician is worth their weight in gold. If the system goes down, if the process goes down, invariably you have to get in the code now, you have to get in the computer to troubleshoot things. So it's not your grandfather's troubleshooting. It requires a lot higher tech approach. So,
well, you talk about collaboration in the community. You talk about business integration and intern type strategy. What makes these activities or these efforts appealing to particularly Chipola College here?
You know, businesses are becoming concerned. You know, we've learned through Northwest Florida Manufacturing Council, which we're a member of, that by 2030, 77% of the baby boomers that are skilled will be gone. That evacuation will create a vacuum. And what we're learning is that collaboration means hook in with these businesses. Locally in 12 county region, 3,400 jobs are going to be needed, in either new or replacement, within the next 5 years. Our education systems are set up to only produce about 850 of those. So we're, you know, one-fourth of what we need. So collaboration, the issue with collaboration is, how do you devise new programming that meets the real needs of the company? Collaboration has been going on through us being involved with you at Florida's Great Northwest, with Opportunity Florida. You'll often see us, and our president, in fact, is out of the manufacturing industry, highly committed to business success. And you'll see us at regional career fairs, at the recent MAF Manufacturing Summit. And collaboration really has to do with, in a diversified economy, you have to get into the heads of what the business people want and need, and then you have to meet those needs. Without that, we won't be successful in the long run.
Well, that's a good point. We're going to jump now to you, John, and talk about your tech garage. Yeah. And this is pretty cool. I know that our audience is going to be to see a lot of the shots here. And how did this come about, the tech garage at Chipola here?
Yeah, it's a long road. It actually started right here. He said industry business partnerships. I mean, you know, our program was successful and was nationally recognized due to these industry business partnerships from the get-go. We started out right here at Chipola. Royce Reagan asked me to do a TV show and get some information out to the public about automotive. And we took that and we just ran with it. Shopware, there was a need in this industry. I think a lot of the videos were outdated and some things were going on. So a producer in New York called Shopware, which is nationally renowned for all the training videos for automotive programs around the nation. And they actually contracted us. They said, well, listen, can you change it? Can you make some of this more interesting? Some of the multimedia, some of the way these kids learn, we had to adapt to it. I mean, you can't stand up there and lecture for 2 hours. I mean, that's not how it works anymore. These kids want that interaction. They want to move. They want to move from one thing to the next thing. So the videos had to do the same thing. So when we found that, we started doing them. We went down to Tampa and we filmed it with Brenton Productions, which is Two Guys Garage and Truck U. And they took the lead role, and we went down there and we filmed these videos and put together a package of auto engine performance and brakes, and they sold nationwide throughout the whole nation for all the automotive programs. And through that, the feedback was, wow, I mean, you know, this is fast paced, it's moving, it's interesting, these kids are getting it. So once again, we just getting with industry and seeing what they needed, we were filling a void. And from there, it just snowballed. We got calls from Gates to do some training from them. We got calls from Castro, Oil. So we started forming all these industry partners as we're going along, Auto Value being a big one. And then what happened after that is, as more of these training videos got out there, Advanced Auto Parts, which is now CarQuest and Worldpac, they're the largest parts manufacturer in the world, they said they saw some of the videos. And they asked us, well, listen, we want to train all of our employees. How's the best way to sell parts is to educate our parts people on how the parts do, the functionality of the parts, and maybe even a little diagnostics on the parts. So what happened is we put together a 125 video set, and Chipola then jumped on board and said, hey, we can do that right here. So we started filming it right here with administration support, industry support, everybody just gathered around. Like Mr. Gilmore said, the five county areas, our dealership sent us cars, new technologies, new transmissions. I mean, just all the way from Pensacola down to South Florida. I mean, it was just endless how what people wanted to get in there and just fill this need, not so much just as far as filming and, you know, here's a product out there, but there's really a need. There's a need for this new technology, and there's need to reach these kids, or we're going to have this huge void in the workforce that we can't fill. I mean, our placement rate at the college is 98%. We can't even get them through the 1,800 hours, yeah. And these dealerships are taking them out there to work. So with that, we did the whole training package for Advance Auto Parts. Now that's nationwide. All their employees have to watch it, just like Walmart would go in as an orientation. They have to watch this and learn about parts. Well, they won a national award for their training and their workforce and their programs with this whole curriculum-based learning management system that they put in place in Advance. And that got out there too. And then Velocity called us up and says, hey, we need to do a TV show on that premise. It's the same thing. And, you know, well, that's weird. An educational show on television, you know, that really is not interesting. And it was the method of it. We call it entertainment kind of education at the same time. We just make it real fast paced. So they approached us. They come down with a partnership with the college. They said they want to film it out of Bristol, Tennessee. And the college was very instrumental, said, no, do it here. And that was a huge marriage between industry and education and you know, the Florida Northwest and everything that's going on, because now we have the vendors all coming here. So that's probably the ultimate goal of the show.
So this is the first auto ed program to be televised as such. How does it compare to what dealerships do, for example, or companies that are in the parts business that are doing training also? Do you compete with that, or is it are they looking at it as a more of a beneficial factor for them to help educate those students out there about the auto industry?
Right, and that's the beauty of it. It's they call it a heavy do-it-yourselfer. They want to reach the guy that wants to go out and do weekend work on their cars. But because here at the college, we have all the technology. I mean, we have a trainer from Console Lab. They sent us with an air conditioning system that actually has glass tubes that shows the Freon changing states and to get inside the component. So what we found is industry said, hey, if we can teach how the component works and what's going on, I don't have to sit up there and do a 30-minute sales pitch. Like you see some of those shows out there, they just, you know, this, and this. It's not about that. We just teach and the parts will sell themselves. So all of a sudden, Standard Motor Parts, Armored Group, STP, every vendor that sells to Advance is just jumping at the bit to come on board. So we have a vendor segment in the show. We have an email segment in the show. So we have the do-it-yourselfer can go out and fix their own car. And then we also take it to a technical level to where these dealerships, these auto parts stores, everybody can use it. So it's a little different. It's not, you know, fire, flames, and all the fun stuff in a sitcom that would be at, you know, 8 o'clock, but for an audience at 8 Eastern time, 7 Central time on a Saturday and Sunday morning. We got a lot of feedback. It aired already this weekend, and we got a lot of feedback that we've never seen it portrayed in that way, and I've learned so much. And I think that's what the people are missing. There's no fluff. It's just, this is how it works. This is the system. Here's to diagnose it, and here's how you can fix it, empowering you to go out and do it. And if you don't do it, at least now you're more comfortable to take it to a shop and get it done.
Yeah. Well, I saw a little bit of the clip that you showed us, and for a particular car, I think it was a Mustang.
Right.
And I thought that was fascinating. You know, there's got to be a million people out there looking for that answers to their particular vehicle as well. And I've gone online myself and found answers to questions I had about my vehicles. But this is even better because it shows you, you know, what your problem may be and how to correct it. That's a wonderful tool. You know?
Yeah.
Economic development, back to you, Darwin. You know, this is, this all ties together, but there's another method here that, I say method to madness, but the fact that Northwest Florida, particularly this part of Northwest Florida, is seriously looking at what we call a mega site in terms of auto manufacturer or assembly operation. Tell us why, how that ties in with what's going on with this particular program.
We really want to capitalize on this, Larry. You know, John has done a phenomenal job and is so willing to support this process. What we're after, you know, with the mega site here, you also have a pony site to the mega site for additional companies to locate.
Right.
And, you know, we're looking at this as a five-year strategic plan that was laid out by the state of Florida on economy, says everyone needs to align. You know, everyone needs to align their missions, plans, so that you can be more successful. So recently, Chipola sponsored, was one of the sponsors of a trade and logistics rollout. The meeting here informed us that the Northwest Florida region is a strategic hub for serving the Mexico region. And Mexico happens to be a very significant automaker. So positioned where we are, we can serve, of course, the southeastern U.S., but we can also serve Mexico and South America. Mm-hmm. What we're wanting to do with a dozen or more key manufacturers and distributors that are associated with the Advanced Auto Parts program, we're wanting to broker relationships. We're wanting to network and bring these people together with our local EDC professionals and see what the plans might be on both sides. And as our EDC people pitch their assets here locally, there may be a fit. And what we're wanting to do is augment what's being done with the marketing of the mega site by marketing a lot of the smaller sites to some of these organizations that serve the major automotive giant.
Yes, you know, the it's not too far-fetched to have a site, a mega site, which is 800 acres or greater, and then have a program like the Tech Ed program, our auto tech program, be visualized for them and let some of the companies, what we call OEMs, original equipment manufacturers, and suppliers, see what's happening in this part of the state at Chipola College and the regionalization collaboration taking place among the EDOs at this point, and what you're doing. That's a perfect fit. That is economic development. It feels so good to know that you get it and you understand our role, and we're starting to understand better the college's role as well.
We're so encouraged. We learned at the mega site unveiling that I think the economic impact across Alabama, southern Alabama, and northern Florida could be upwards of around $800 million. So you're chasing a billion-dollar impact when you begin to search out and bring in automotive-related manufacturing and distribution.
You know, we've learned from some of the companies and suppliers we've talked to and the EDOs at Florida's Great Northwest that they are looking for communities that have programs in place like this. Not that they would put it in place. Everyone says they'll do that.
Right.
But when the programs are in place like this, the companies are more encouraged to take a closer look at the communities because they know that the community is gearing up for their particular needs. And the training aspect, the technical training aspect, as you said, both of you, is critical to our future. And I think the more we can educate, you know, the students and their parents about how important and what a factor and how much money they could make in these careers and enjoy it.
That's right.
That's the selling point that we have to get across, I think.
And that in the industry, I mean, the passion and the aggressiveness, I guess, of Chipola, you know, if Caterpillar wants to build a plant here, you know, in no time we can have a facility up and do their training. I mean, we have the capability to do that, you know, Armored Group, STP, parts houses. I mean, Federated comes in, Advance comes in, and they want to put a distribution center here. You know, we can switch gears just that quickly. If they want to support a training center here or their employees, we just did the Florida Department of Transportation. We did their training here, their updated training for their employees right
customized
here.
Customized training that John developed for them to meet their specific needs, and that's what we're about. We're about connecting with what they really need.
Do you see a good receptive audience in terms of the students that are coming to the college here?
You know, the ones that are here, certainly, you know, I think you brought it up earlier and we've talked about here with our administration. You know, what we want to do is invite the students to come in and see. In this 15 to 22 year age range, a lot of kids are struggling to determine who they are, what they're good at. And what we're really trying to highlight is that workforce is something you should really investigate. You know, it's worth assessing, analyzing, because you may come in and find your niche. You may not enjoy some of the gen ed core things, and you may find yourself frustrated in education until you find that spark. All these guys know these phones and the technology and the iPads. It really turns them on. So when you look at workforce, even in welding, we got a nice welding program up here. The welding is now tied into the millwright program. We're placing welding students in local companies and they're watching these millwrights learn. They turn on because they realize that this is all the technology that's involved in this current economy is stimulating to them. So they want to learn how it connects. They want to learn how it connects to who they are and what they're good at.
You know, and we have to try to keep those students that have gotten those educations here. And the best way to get and keep them here is to provide them with companies that can employ them in the skills that they've learned from what you're teaching them, John. Is that right?
Yeah, and the gold collar worker. I mean, there's been a paradigm shift in education, but there needs to be a lot more. I mean, we go into the high schools or we go into the middle schools, and you know, we're still, you know, we're not sitting here with a rag in our pocket and all dirty and, you know, making $9 an hour. I mean, you know, these guys are leaving this program making $30,000, $50,000, $80,000, $90,000 in 5 years. I mean, that's a gold collar job. And I think if we switch that thinking and a paradigm shift happens in education to where, you know, workforce is not that stepchild down the hill, you know, we're putting out there we're meeting a lot of needs and we're putting out some real qualified workforce out there.
You know, this is something that we'll talk about with the EDOs at our marketing meeting too, because I think this is a great example of trying to promote the technical programs that are so important today, because like you said, what was that ratio again? It was one to seven. That's pretty impressive. I didn't know that. But I appreciate that. We've got a couple more minutes, maybe talk a little bit about some of your other programs, your engineering program that you've got coming about this summer.
Great. There's a lot of good schools, you know, in the Panhandle. But we're going to offer two new degrees coming up this year. One is a civil engineering technology degree. Essentially, I think of it as a construction-oriented degree. It's an outside degree where you're building roads, bridges, structures. It relates to people like DOT, surveying, engineering services, testing. It'll be a broad, multi-craft type of an AS degree. Really excited about that, and in partnership already with a couple of organizations. Secondly, we'll be launching an industrial maintenance program, which formerly is called engineering technology, but it has two aspects to it, Larry. One is it's an industrial maintenance program for the plant. It's kind of an inside job. It's inside a plant, inside a factory. You can fix anything that's broken. You can run the processes. But also, it's robust enough in terms of the curriculum to attract an automotive manufacturer that demands advanced manufacturing. The hydraulics, pneumatics, motors, PLCs, all of those will be embodied in that program. So Excellent. We're really excited about those two.
Now, I'm sure you've done your research ahead of time to know that those programs are becoming on the rise in terms of values today in the economy, not only the local economy, but the national economy. And you've done your research, so those programs you feel will kick off to be very successful, I'm sure.
Sure. We've worked closely with CareerSource Chipola. They're great partners, and we feel real good that we're going to hit the targets here.
Excellent. Well, any last words about your garage tech?
Yeah, I'm excited. Saturday and Sunday mornings, 7 a.m. Central Time. Yeah, just watch it, and we get a good audience, we get a good viewing, and we can use it for a vehicle. I mean, just it benefits our kids. We get so many donations to the college just because we're shooting here with equipment, and the kids are now nationally renowned and jobs, and just it helps out the whole region, so absolutely.
Thank you. Thanks, John. And Darwin, any last comments about Chipola College? You know, it's great to be here.
We're just excited to be part of this region. You know, we see it a privilege to be involved in this. You know, when nobody gets to throw around world class and get away with it. But what I can say is this truly demonstrates we're a world class organization in terms of how we can teach. You know, this guy represents that.
That's great. Well, it's once again back to the collaboration as we close out today's show. I think that we've really hit the point at home in terms of how important it is for the collaboration, the training aspect of it, and economic development, you know. And, you know, I have to sing that tune all the time, and I like doing that, but it's nice to hear it from someone else too. So I appreciate that.
Thank you.
I hope you enjoyed the show, Darwin, John, myself, and we had a good time. We're here in the tech garage. It doesn't look like a garage. It's pretty clean. Probably the cleanest garage I've been in. Thank you for joining us today. I hope you enjoyed the show, and tune in next time. Thank you.